All right, I always love a good car hacking story, and these researchers just showed how they can remotely hack into a Nissan. They found about 8 vulnerabilities in total from a 2022 Nissan Leaf. This style of attack would work on other cars. You would just have to find the vulnerabilities that they found in these other manufacturers. I want to cut right to the demo so you guys can see the hack as it's going on. So right off the bat, first of all, A+, highly produced demo. Kudos for not trying to do this live on air, on stage in Black Hat Asia. So the hack initially needs Bluetooth access. I'll pull up the slides and show you how they do the whole attack. All right, starting monitoring now. All right, let me get my face out of the way. So right off the bat, they're showing this cool interface that they built to like track the location of the car. So GPS tracking is live, it's working. Now they can deface so they can show, oh look, hacked by PC Automotive, cool. I'm gonna stop the deface. This is just standard POC stuff. The crazy part is I'm pretty sure they got access to everything, including steering. Oh, okay, recording audio. So now you can listen into a car that you've hacked into and spy on their conversations on their microphone. All right, now I think you, at the same time you can play audio. So you can start Rickrolling everyone while they're driving. Okay, they were recording audio, then they downloaded it, and now they played it on their side, and then they played the audio back into the car. So, hey, we were listening on you. Here's your voices back to you. Downloading screenshots of the infotainment system. All right, now they said body controls. So they stopped the car. They honked the car. They moved the mirrors on the car. They started the wipers on the car. Sorry, it doesn't look like they actually stopped it in their command. I think they stopped it for safety reasons themselves, but they can steer the car. So yes, even while it's moving, they could send that steering command. Wipers on and everything. Send the steering wheel while it's moving. Okay. I'm nervous for them. They've got trees. They've got signs. Whoop. Okay. They just did a little little jaunt. And then they pulled into a pretty sick house, and that was the end of the demo. Okay, cool. All right. Very cool demo. Well produced. Point proven. How the hell did you do that? To talk about that, they put out their Black Hat Asia slides, all 118 of them. This is a very dense slide deck filled with a lot of technical detail. Not going to go into all of it, obviously. I wanted to show you a few things. First of all, shout out to the researchers who did the work. Kudos. Very cool. Second, the car that they did it on was a second-gen Nissan Leaf. Apparently, they found a lot of this over 18 months ago. It's taken a long time to work with Nissan to get this fixed and responsibly disclosed. The other interesting part, they went to a bunch of junkyards to piece together a bunch of the internals to basically create this test rig. So instead of testing on a car, they've got all of like the guts of the computers of the car here, the infotainment system, the dash electronics, all the wiring, everything. So this is what they actually were working on so that they weren't working on an actual car. They wound up looking into the anti-theft protections and figuring out how to actually bypass the anti-theft. Basically, there were some protections in anti-theft that they wrote a Python script to solve every possible solution for, and that let them in. The infotainment system is actually where they found a bunch of the vulnerabilities that we'll get to. And I saw that a lot of the vulnerabilities required Bluetooth. And so I was like, okay, well then how is this remote if it requires Bluetooth? Turns out you just needed to exploit Bluetooth to get into the car to begin with, not physically into the car, to hack into the car to begin with. And then they exploited a bunch of other vulnerabilities to maintain persistence. It also seems they were able to pair Bluetooth that first time without like tricking the user in some way. It seems like they were able to jam the system that would force the user to a specific menu that then they were able to zero click pair the Bluetooth with. So they're calling that a half click. I'm guessing they're calling it a half click because it's not like the user is saying, yes, pair this weird hacker device. The user just has to go to a specific menu while the hacker is there trying to get in, and then it'll auto pair. They said they could achieve this via jamming it. All right, now I want to skip to basically the end of this whole thing. If you want to read the code and like how they found the buffer overflows and all of this, feel free to do so. Not going to do that on the YouTube video. The gist of everything I'm scrolling past right now, if you're interested, is they sent a specially crafted Bluetooth request because the infotainment system was not checking the size properly of the message. So basically they sent an oversized message, which then overflowed them into parts of the code where they could start running their own commands. I skipped all the way down to the end of this slide deck to show you the list of vulnerabilities they found. A lot of these things that if you said leading to RCE, if you see that in the vulnerability name, any one of those vulnerabilities could be used for that initial access. Then a lot of these other vulnerabilities are having to do with persistence, the anti-theft bypass, like I talked about at the beginning, or any other vulnerabilities that they used, A, in this attack chain to do what I showed you in the demo, or just in general that they found while they were doing their research. Like I said, this timeline goes back to 2023. February 2023, the team at PC Automotive sends an advisory to the Nissan team. I'm sorry, my American is showing February 2023. I just realized that this is August. And then all the way to last month, 2025, where they got their last CVE. It took from August to January for Nissan to acknowledge it and start planning their mitigations. And then up until last month, the team was still getting CVEs assigned for this stuff. Nissan hasn't publicly talked about their mitigation plans for any of these things, though I do think they are currently mitigating. All right, so here's the attack outline. So these are the slides that I want to show through. Again, this is all the way at the end of the presentation, but this is how they did that demo that we just showed you. So right off the bat, that first one click or half click Bluetooth exploitation, they got to get on the car initially via this buffer overflow. Then they use a vulnerability further down in the hardware to actually install persistence, meaning this will even survive a reboot of the car. So you got that hack from the Bluetooth. Now you can go buzz off. You don't have to be near the car anymore. You now have persistence. Then they had to find a vulnerability in order to send commands from a server to the car. So you saw that in the demo where they were clicking the buttons to like unlock the doors, move the mirrors, steer the wheel. Those commands had to be sent to the car somehow. And that's not the kind of command that the car is used to receiving. So this is again, a different vulnerability. And then fourth, the vulnerability of actually controlling those critical body elements. So not just the hack, okay, I can run code, not just establish persistence, not just send commands, but even then the car should have protections in place for all of those things and all of those pieces of code failing. They should not then be able to turn the steering wheel and do all this other stuff. Really good work by the research team. Again, this is specific to this infotainment system at Nissan, and I'm sure they're fixing or fixed all of these vulnerabilities. But that being said, buffer overflows exist in a lot of code. This is why this kind of research is important. A lot of this stuff is demonstrated at contests like Pwn to Own, where people are paying out bug bounties to researchers for finding these types of vulnerabilities. Thankfully, a lot of the research that we see about this is from researchers and not from threat actors. I don't know, I'm waiting for the day where a crew is smart enough, finds some of these vulnerabilities, goes around on a mysterious car heist that no one can figure out how they're getting into the cars or controlling the cars because it's all happening remotely. And you got to imagine that's just going to sow chaos. It's really hard to trace this kind of stuff. It's not like these cars are sending their logs of their access logs back somewhere that some sort of SIM is monitoring or anything like that. All right, like I said, love a good car hacking video. If you like this one, please do all the YouTube things down below. Like, comment, share, tell your mom. I already sent this out in my newsletter a few days ago. You could have. Thanks for watching. Follow for more cybersecurity.